ಶ್ರೀರಾಧೇ ನಮ ಕುಂಜ ನಾಗರಿಕವ ಪ್ರೀತಾಸ್ಮಿ ದಾಸೋತ್ಸವ ಹೇ ವೇದಾಪುರ ಕುಸುಮ ಚಯನ ಸುಮ್ರತ ಕಂಠಕಾಂಕೋ ವಕ್ತೋದಸ್ಯಾಸ್ತಿಲಕ ವಿಲಯೋ.
I'm inside the temple now. No, I'm inside the outside of the temple now. The temple's actually closed, but it's really quiet here. Nobody's here because of the corona. Everything's kind of closed down, but we're here to document the cleanup that's going on around here, that they're cleaning up the outsides of the grounds all over the area, outside the temple and outside the palace. They're doing cleanup, and we're here to document that and bring that beautiful seva to you, so you can enjoy and be part of the new beauty, the wondrous beauty of this temple, and the cleaning operation that's going on by the people of Barsana, who love Radharani and she loves Krishna.
This is Barsana Dham. We are at the ancient village of Barsana. It used to be a village, of course now it's turned into a town, but this is where Srimati Radharani, she grew up. These are the grounds upon which she performed all her pastimes. The eight gopis' villages are also just around here in the vicinity. 4 kilometers down the road is Nandagram, or the village where Krishna and Nanda Baba, they lived. So this is very historic grounds. And it's a very holy place, because Srimati Radharani, she is the queen of the realm of divine love. Because of her significance in this spiritual world, in the realm of spirit, a lot of people come here for darshan, for paying their respects. And, you know, from ancient times, for example, this palace was built by the kings of Jaipur. And then the temple behind us was built by some big businessmen like about 100 years ago. To glorify Srimati Radharani, you see. Now, what we're doing over here is a cleanup job, because, I mean, this is such a significant holy place. So many visitors come from all over the world here to offer their respects and take darshan. So basically, what we're doing is we're going through the hill, the sides of the palace, the sides of the temple, and picking up old garbage that's been just accumulating over the past decades. We've been at it for the past like 3 weeks now. About 60, 70 tractor loads of plastic and rubble and rubbish have been taken down the hill, planning to make beautiful, you know, sitting areas with rocks underneath trees, frame the trees, you know, like bring the trees out. Put nice grass, you know, plant specific trees that are good for shade and good for birds, like the banyan tree, the peepal tree. I think every single tree would be glorified if they were placed on this on this hill range, you know. So we want to really do a nice plantation, create spaces underneath shady trees that are existing, so that visitors and sadhus, they can come, meditate, chant, read, you know, just be in this atmosphere of Barsana, be in the energy field of Srimati Radharani's love. And this is our mission, this is our goal, to beautify the gardens of the queen of the cosmos, Srimati Radharani. There's plenty of blessings in this realm of divine love. It is abundant. It is for those who want. If you want, she's willing. She's willing, she's calling, come. But in order for you to receive it, you have to come. If you want to bathe in the greatest body of water known as the ocean, you have to come to the ocean. Everyone, by their body, by their mind, by their wealth, however, like tan, man, or dhan, however you can, come and engage yourself in this most sublime, most glorified service of serving Srimati Radharani's gardens. This is my humble request to you all, that please take this opportunity to join somehow or other in this glorious seva of the gardens of Srimati Radharani. Thank you very much.
So beautiful. I mean, it's kind of sad there's no people here, but it's kind of nice. Got the place all to myself. All to myself, it's beautiful. Rade, rade.